Hare Krishna devotees, please accept my humble obeisances. All glory to Prabhupada. We welcome devotees to our morning Bhagavatam class. This morning we will be speaking on two verses, Srimad-Bhagavatam, Canto 1, Chapter 6, Verse 29 and 30. And the topic is Srila Narada Muni's Conversations with Srila Vyasadeva. And the class will be given by His Holiness Candramauli Swami. Hare Krishna Maharaj, please accept my humble obeisances. All glories to you and all glories to Srila Prabhupada.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Bol Maharaj.
So, Kaupantan idam adaya sanyayam vasyu danvataham shishyasyur anupranam vivishantar aham vivaho. At the end of the millennium, when the personality of Godhead, Lord Narayan, lay down within the water of devastation, Brahman began to enter into him along with the creative elements. And I also entered through this breathing. Srila Prabhupada's purport, Narada is known as the son of Brahma, as Lord Krishna is known as the son of Vasudeva. The personality of Godhead and his liberated devotees like a Narada appear in the material world by the same process. As it's said in the Bhagavad Gita, the birth and activities of the Lord are divyam, transcendental. Therefore, according to authorized opinion, the birth of Narada as the son of Brahma is also a transcendental pastime. His appearance and disappearance are practically on the same level as that of the Lord. The Lord and his devotees are therefore simultaneously one and different. As spiritual entities, they belong to the same category of transcenders.
Maharaj, would you like us to go to the next verse, or would you like to break it up however you would like us to do?
All right, I'll start here. We can just speak on this one. Om Gyanti Mirandasya Gyanajana Salakaya Chaksun Militam Yena Tasmai Shri Guruve Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manobhistam Stapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Dadati Swam Padati Kam Ma Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prasthaya Bhutale Srimakti Bhakti Vedanta Swami Iti Namine Namaste Saraswati Deve Gaudavani Pacharine Nirvishesa Sunyavadi Paskyatya De Sitarine Vajakalpa Tarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Pavacha Patitanam Pavane Vyo Vaishnavi Vyo Namaha Namaha Jai Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhar Sivasati Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. Here we're hearing about Narada Muni, and he's describing his appearance as Sri Narada Muni. In the earlier chapters, we heard about his previous sojourn as he became fully self-realized and actually had the personal darshan of the Lord at least one time in that life. And the Lord disappeared from him, and that was his only experience. But Sri Narada Muni is an interesting personality because he is, as it says here, he's in the same category as the Lord. He's a completely pure spiritual personality. He's completely transcendental, and he has a particular feature that practically no one else has, and that is that he can go anywhere and anywhere at any time. He can travel through all of the material universes. He can go to the spiritual world. He can leave the spiritual world and come back. He is known as a liberated spaceman, completely free from any material taints. And his mission is to glorify the Lord and to inspire and to assist in Lord Krishna's pastimes in the material world. He facilitates sometimes the demoniac principles, as appears to be, in order to bring about Krishna's appearance in a more faster way, like when he encouraged Kamsa to not to be lax and take heed, because the demigods are planning to destroy him and Krishna has already taken birth. When he told that to Kamsa, Kamsa became completely alarmed. And then he started to increase his atrocities. And then later on, Narada again comes to Kamsa. This is after Krishna's been in Vrindavan for many, many years. And Krishna's grown up, he's performing his pastime. Now Narada says that, you know, you have to be careful. You know, Krishna's now, you know, the demons you're sending to Vrindavan, he's killing them. And so you should make a plan. So Narada actually tricked Kamsa into making a plan for his own death, because he knows no one could kill Krishna. So Narada's plan was to invite, to have Kamsa invite Krishna to come to Mathura to see, to be at the capital, to see the beautiful scenery there, to see how the everything is being conducted. And so the plan was actually to invite Krishna to come. And then when he gets there, they will have so many plans to try to kill him. First plan was he calls an elephant keeper and says that the elephant keeper who keeps this big elephant known as Kula Vyapida. And this elephant is very fierce and huge. Well, that was the first thing. If he got through there, then the two wrestlers, Chanur and Mastika, would challenge him to a wrestling match, him and Balaram both. And then that would be the way to destroy these two boys. So the plan was in place, and now they had to invite Krishna to come. So what was the next plan? Krishna calls Akura. I'm sorry. Kamsa calls Akura and reveals his plan, how he's going to be king of the world, destroy all his particular enemies, and invite Krishna and Balaram to take part in activities in the kingdom, and then plan for destroying Krishna and Balaram. Of course, Akura, he's a dutiful subject within the kingdom, and he goes along with Kamsa's plan, agreeing to be a messenger to invite Krishna to come out of Vrindavan and into Mathura. But in his mind, he knows that this is the plan for Krishna to destroy. Akura is a devotee, but he also works under the care of Kamsa. So dutifully, he carries out that order and invites Krishna. So all of this has been inspired by Narada Muni. So you see how much it... And then when Narada comes, and he also comes to Vrindavan to meet Krishna, right after that, he starts to glorify Krishna. And what does he glorify him? How Krishna, in the future, will kill Kamsa, the wrestlers, the elephant, and then take care of the demons like Jarasandha, Shishupal, Dantavarki, Kesiraj. And he lists all of the upcoming pastimes of the Lord, because Narada is Trikalagyan. He knows past, present, and future. So knowing the future means he was able to see how Krishna would very dexterously, with great intelligence, come into the purview of these demons and then dispatch them to the boat of death one after another. which was why, and this was also in glorification of the Lord by Narada, why the Lord appeared in this world is to rid the world of these, many of these demons, along with giving pleasure to his devotees, which is actually the main reason. So Narada, he's not an ordinary person. He's quite powerful, and he's very dear to the Lord, very intimate with the Lord. He can go to Narayan and Vaikuntha, and he can just be there and speak to Narayan, discuss with Narayan like, you know, like a big person discusses with his confidential servants about how things should go on. Narada is very much welcomed into the assembly of Lord Narayan and Vaikuntha. And he also visits Krishna also. So he is a pretty amazing personality. As it says here, his appearance and disappearance, as he appeared as the son of Lord Brahma, and before there disappeared in his previous sojourn, are practically on the same level as that of the Lord. The Lord and his devotees are simultaneously one and different in spiritual entities. We get a little bit of the glories of Sri Narada Muni. So we can go on to the next verse.
Vrinda, can you go to the next verse?
Sarasya Yuga Paryantan Paryante Utai Dedam Sisrik Sataham Marichi Mishra Rishaya Pranibyo Hum Janjire. After 4,300,000,000 solar years, when Brahma awoke to create again by the will of the Lord, all the rishis like Marichi, Angira, Atri, and so on were created from the transcendental body of the Lord. And Narada says, I also appeared along with them. Purport. The duration of a day in the life of Brahma is 4,320,000,000 solar years. This is stated also in the Bhagavad Gita. So for this period, Brahmaji rests in yoga nidra within the body of Garbhadakshay Vishnu, the generator of Brahma. Thus, after the sleeping period of Brahma, when there is again creation by the will of the Lord through the agency of Brahma, all the great rishis again appear from different parts of the transcendental body, and Narada also appears. This means that Narada appears in the same transcendental body, just as a man awakes from sleep in the same body. Sri Narada is eternally free to move in all parts of the transcendental and material creations of the Almighty. He appears and disappears in his own transcendental body, which is without distinction of body and soul, unlike conditioned beings. The conditioned soul is, by nature, part and parcel of Krishna, but being conditioned means having a material body. And body means limitation. Body means distraction. As soon as we take on a material body, we pretty much forget and lose it about our own real identity. And therefore, we find ourselves acting simply on the body that we have and the extensions of the body that come along with having that particular body, such as our nationalities, gender, relationships with others based on that particular role we play, either as father, mother, daughter, son, or even in the social and political arenas we play roles. So all of these different disguises we put upon ourselves in the form of the soul in the form of the body, the soul gets covered. But here you see Narada Muni is completely distinct from that. When he moves freely through, he appears and disappears in the same body that he has. He doesn't lose his body. His body is always spiritual. And because he has attained complete transcendental consciousness. And as we mentioned earlier, he knows past, present, and future. So we hear a little bit here about the beginning of creation, how at the beginning of the millennium, great personalities reappeared to assist Lord Brahma. And these are progenitors, and they're also great sages who have a role in bringing about the next millennium. The ones that are mentioned here are Marichi, Angira, and Atri. And of course, Brahma has 10 sons. And Brahma's body is transcendental in that it has no physical nature. It's made out of pure intelligence. So his body is made out of pure intelligence. It's not that he doesn't have a gross body, he has a subtle body. Brahma lives in himself, in the material world, in a subtle body of mind, ego, and intelligence. And he is principal Maha intelligence. So he functions on a level of intelligence. So when the millennium is created, he appears, and out of his body comes 10 personalities who come from different parts of the body. They come from his navel, they come from his chest, they come from his head, they come from his arms, and they also come from his mind. So Narada is the manifestation of one of the initial personalities who appear after the appearance of Lord Brahma to assist Lord Brahma in bringing about the spiritual aspect of creation. And his body is completely spiritual. It has no material contaminations. And so it's interesting because this millennium happens regularly. It's like clockwork. Here, a day of Brahma is 4,320,000,000 years. His night is of equal. So you double that and you get 8,640,000,000 solar years at one day in the life of Brahma. And Brahma lives for 100 years. So doing the multiplication, you get 311,040,000,000,000 years of the lifetime of Lord Brahma to compare with earthly years. And that's a fantastic amount of time compared to us. But the higher you go in the material realm, the slower time moves. Time moves. The more you go down, the faster time moves. The more you go up, the more the slower time moves. So Brahma lives only 100 years of his life, just like it says, Prabhupada explains it. An ant or an insect sometimes will take birth in the evening, and by the morning, it is no longer living. It's gone through its whole life cycle. Birth, producing children, maintaining children, and going and dying, actually. So that short apparent lifetime compared to us is 100 years for that insect. In the same way, Brahma is also 100 years compared to our time period, but it's all relative to his particular body. So it's mentioned that in this Kali Yuga, everyone lives for 100 years, including Lord Brahma. And that all, it's all relative time. But in the realm of existence where each of these occur, it's only 100 years. So Brahma doesn't live a long time compared to 100 years of Brahma's life. But compared to us, who live on this level, it's a very long time. So time is relative. Time is always moving in a certain direction to bring about something and take away something. Therefore, one should be very careful to use our time in Krishna consciousness to the best possible. But sometimes devotees fall into this idea that, well, you know, I'm young. And we get this idea that youth means, you know, I got a long time to go yet. And even if you live a complete lifespan, it's not very long anyway. But even if you think like that, then you should also know that no amount of time is guaranteed to any living entity. We are under the destiny of the Lord. And therefore, we have a particular time where we're meant to wrap up our activities in this particular body and move on to the next situation. So therefore, using time wisely, I think Bhakti Tirtha Swami very nicely illustrated that in his book, Beggar Number 4, which is called Die Before Dying. He talks about the utilization of the moments that have been given to him before he departs the body. His situation was just like Maharaj Prikshit's, in the sense that he could understand time was very short and soon I will have to leave, and therefore he made the best use of that time by becoming completely Krishna conscious. So that same message is there for us. In fact, when Bhakti Tirtha Swami was diagnosed as terminal cancer and nothing had worked in order to change it, he started to appear regularly in his assembly with his devotees just to remind him, everyone, that what I'm going through, you'll also have to go through. So you should also understand the importance of preparing for your next body. People don't think like that. They think, let me live my life now, and in the future, whatever comes will come. But that's not very intelligent, because that means not planning, and not planning means being subjected to a wider plan or a broader plan. And that means Maya will find opportunities to give us her plan, which will be not beneficial to us. So therefore, one should be very careful and very much aware of the time factor and use it in the best possible way. Otherwise, wasting time is more precious than wasting anything. As Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati has said that money is valuable, but time is precious. Time is more valuable than money, because money can be gotten and can be lost and got and regained again, but time only goes in one direction. And so there's one verse in the Srimad-Bhagavatam in the second canto, third chapter, it's verse number 17. It says, both with the rising and the setting of the sun, another day is lost and one is closer to death, except, and the verse goes on to say, except for those who utilize their time to glorify the all-good personality of Godhead. So time doesn't touch those who are engaged in transcendental activities, especially hearing and chanting the glories of the Lord. Why? Because that's on the transcendental platform, where material time is not influential. Material time is only influential within the three modes of material nature, but one is engaged in devotional service fully, then one is above the three modes of material nature, and their consciousness is of the same nature. So the time factor is not there for them, although we say the material body will leave at a certain time, but they have transcended the material body. Therefore, as the body goes, they are not disturbed. They simply move on to their next destination as given to us by their present activities. And that's very important to understand, because otherwise we have a tendency to not take the time given to us as important. We waste time, and it's a very shameful form of waste, because it's the most valuable thing. Prabhupada would also illustrate this. He would make experiments in public. He would give a class, and then he would say, "Oh, it is now 7:29 on December 12th, 1973. And then he would wait. And then now he'd say, "Now it's September, it is 7:30 on the same day at the same place." So where is that 1 minute? It's gone. You can't buy it back. You may have all the wealth in the world, but still you're not able to buy it back, because time is Krishna's energy to bring about, to move along, and to destroy everything material. Time does that, those three things. It brings about, it moves you along, and then it pretty much disappears. So one who's actually intelligent will use time for the best, in the best possible way. That's become Krishna conscious. Sometimes we think, "What am I going to do now? I don't have anything to do." Yes, you do. There's always something to do. You can read a book. You can read, or you can chant Hare Krishna. Either one. Those are the best use of time. Not only are they devotional activities, but they are the essence of devotional. They have a hearing and chanting the glories of the Lord. So we are in a good position to use time in the best possible way when we always remember how valuable time is and how short life is. Life is very, very short. As Prabhupada tells the story of Lomasa Rish. Lomasa Rish was a very hairy sage, and he lived on the banks of a holy river. He didn't have any dwelling to live in, and he was always doing his prayer and meditation. He had gathered a few followers that had come by their own volition, and they took shelter of him. So their followers were seeing that our guru, he's not getting proper shelter, so let's offer to build him a house. Now, this Lomasa Rish had a benediction that for every hair on his body, he could live 1 day of Brahma. So we see, we have the length of one day of Brahma. So Prabhupada goes on to explain, he was a very hairy sage. He had many, much hair. So when his disciples, followers came and said, "Guru Maharaj, I can see, you know, you don't have any dwelling. You're living on the banks of the river. So let us build you a cottage." And immediately he responded, "Well, actually, you know, I'm not going to be here very long, so don't bother. So you might think, well, he, compared to his duration of life, ours is completely insignificant, unmeasurable. But he was thinking, with such a long duration of life, it is nothing. It's really short, because in the course of material time, it is simply a flash. It comes and it goes. Therefore, utilizing time in the best possible way is a feature of Krishna consciousness." Okay, so we'll stop there and see if there's any questions or comments.
Thank you so much, Maharaj, for addressing key points in this both the verses, and I thank you for giving us the opportunity to ask questions. If there are any questions from devotees, any clarification, please do unmute yourself and ask. I'm going down the list to see that I don't miss anyone. Maharaj, if I can start by asking a question. When you mentioned earlier on that once we take this material body, we forget ourselves, you know, our true identity. And when a devotee takes to the path of Krishna consciousness and realizes the purpose of their life, and then they go to the extreme of saying, oh, but, you know, I really want to end this life. You know, I really want to get free from anarthas. And they become so anxious, like they want it right now. How would you help someone like that, Maharaj?
Well, the process is there. You can accelerate the process, but you can't skirt the process. You can't omit the process. You can accelerate by increasing the quality and quantity of your devotional activities. Yeah, you can chant more, you can read more, you can serve more, you can develop more of the qualities of a Vaishnava. So yeah, your enthusiasm for acceleration has to come in the form of more hearing and chanting the glories of the Lord. Yeah, that's the acceleration process, but the process cannot be, you know, omitted. You have to follow the process. You can't, as one very senior devotee would say, you can't charge the gates of heaven. And there's another one, there's another saying that the door of Vaikuntha has a handle only on the inside, not on the outside. You have to be let in. You can't walk in. So by your own efforts, you can show your enthusiasm and your sincerity, but it's only by the mercy of the Lord that you receive the results.
Mercy. Thank you, Maharaj. Mansi and Diptesh, you can ask a question, Prabhu.
Hare Krishna, Maharaj. Please accept my humble obeisances. All glory to Srila Prabhupada. Thank you, Maharaj, for explaining the importance of time, which needs constant reminder to make sure we are using the best possible way for our advancement. Maharaj, I have a question. I've been meaning to ask you for a few weeks, but I think this is the right topic now for Narad Muni. Maharaj, Narad Muni is mentioned in Srimad-Bhagavatam throughout. He is one of the 12 Mahajans. He's a spiritual master of almost all the personalities in Srimad-Bhagavatam. What is so special about Sri Narad? Because we've got other Mahajans as well. They are briefly mentioned. But Narad Muni, you can, even yesterday I was reading Krishna book and I didn't realize that Narad Muni was there with when the pastimes of the Shyamantaka jewel as well, where he, and also with the bone of Pradyumna as well, where he's telling his story. So I was thinking yesterday as well that he's everywhere and he's, as you said, he goes and foretells like he did with Kamsa. And so what is so special, Maharaj, about Sri Narad?
Well, he is who he is. I don't know. But he's just a great soul. His specialty is that in the life before he became Sri Narada Muni, he actually reached self-realization where he saw the Lord personally, who appeared to him in front of him just for a brief moment. He had perfected his devotional service by taking full shelter of the of the traveling sannyasis, who were all great sages at the time. He got their blessings, he got their mercy, he took their prasadam. And then as a young boy, being without any parents, his mother was later on bitten by a snake and she lost her life. He was only a young boy, but he went traveling, just traveling and meditating on the Lord. And through those meditations, he became perfect and the Lord appeared to him. And but his strong desire to see the Lord and to serve the Lord, you know, pushed him to that point of perfection. And then finally, when he left his body in that next life, he got the position of being Narada Muni, the son of Lord Brahma. And he was born from the mind of Brahma, which means that out of all the sons of Brahma, Brahma had 10 sons, Ulastya, Atri, you can see here Marichi, Angira, who else was there? Also Agastya, I think Astya. There were 10 sons of Brahma. Narada is the most glorious and most powerful. And his desire was just to sing the glories of the Lord. So he attained a particular instrument known as a veena. If you read in the sixth canto, there's a whole verse that is allotted to Narada Muni's singing, describing what he sings. Narada Muni bhajai veena rakika ramana namre. So he goes everywhere, speaking the glories of the Lord, chanting the glories of the Lord, enlightening everyone with the glories of the Lord, and facilitating the pastimes of Sri Krishna. So his specialty, I guess, is that he's been given that service, that he can travel freely, that's mentioned in the previous verse, in and out of the spiritual and material realms at will. He's not restricted. He's completely independent. He goes where he wants, whenever he wants. And he simply acts on behalf of the... He learns what the Lord wants. He's interested in the Lord's pastimes, just like Narada. When Narada saw Krishna in Vrindavan, Narada could understand that Krishna was winding up his pastimes in Vrindavan. That was after Krishna performed his Rasa Lita with the gopis. Right after that, there's a little bit of discussion of some smaller pastimes of Krishna. But Narada appears on the scene right after that, and he understands that Krishna now is going to perform his activities in Mathura. I want to be a part of that. I want to see these activities. And so he makes it a point to appear and assist the Lord in bringing about the demise of all the demons by facilitating Kamsa's activities to invite Krishna to come. So he's a very intricate part of Krishna's pastimes. Just like Purnamasi, she's also, she's Yogamaya. She makes all the arrangements, but Narada takes part in the pastimes and helps to facilitate different aspects of these pastimes. So he's there. He was there with King Yudhisthira. He was there with Vasudev. He was there with many, many great personalities. He was there with Daksha. Daksha was also his brother, one of the son, also another son of Narada Muni. But out of all the great saints and sages, he's the most enlightened.
Thank you, Maharaj. I was also contemplating whilst you were answering that he, if you compare the other Mahajans, they have some specific duty to perform. For example, Bhishmadev, he had a specific duty that he's doing. And so at Yamaraj, he has a specific duty. Whereas with Narad Muni, his specific duty is just glorifying. That's and I think that's what's making him special as well. was just thinking now.
Yeah, that's unique. Mm-hmm. Yeah, Yamaraj, he has his duty. The four Kumaras, they have their duty. Shiva, Brahma, Prahlad, they all play their roles as preceptors for setting down the path of bhakti. Mahajano yena kata supanta. But Narada is outstanding.
Thank you, Maharaj. This has clarified, I think. Thank you. I have been
contemplating. But you can't say he's not on the same level as Lord Shiva, though.
Yes.
Lord Shiva is another Mahajan, because Lord Shiva and Lord Vishnu are practically the same personality. There's a slight difference in Lord Shiva from Lord Vishnu, but they're practically the same.
Thank you, Maharaj. This has helped. Hare Krishna. Mm-hmm.
Thank you, Dipesh Prabhu. Very nice question,
read about his life. There's a whole, I have the book. Are you interested in reading more about great personalities?
Yes, Maharaj.
If you are, I'll be right back. I'll give you a title of a book you should get. And in it is a whole list of about, I don't know, 40 personalities with all their histories, and Narada Muni is one of them. Let me get the title of the book, and you probably can find it in London really easy, because London is a very good supplier of transcendental books. Narada Muni.
That was a very nice question, Dipesh Prabhu. Thank you for asking.
This is one of the most interesting books I've come across. It's called Pauranic, P-A-U-R-A-N-I-C, Charitavali. It's called Legends from the Puranas. Pauranic Charitavali, compiled by Ishwara Das and Bhumipati. Copyright 2018, and it has a listing of about those. Maybe close to 50 personalities. And Narada is not included. Narada, you can find him in the Srimad-Bhagavatam. In the first canto, there is a nice description of Narada Muni. He's not included in this particular book, but there's 50 other great personalities included. These are the histories and lives of these personalities. To give you some, and Angira, Atri, Bart Maharaj, Janaka, Kashyapa, Kratu, Nirga, Muchikunda, Sibi, Pulastya, Rishishringa, Veda Vyas, Yayati. And the list goes on and on and on. Maitreya Muni, Devala, Durvasa, Kardama Muni, so many different personalities. Agastya Muni, really an interesting read. One of my favorite books, because it goes really detailed into the lives of these people where you don't find this information anywhere else. If somebody could write this on the chat, I'll spell it for you.
Maharaj, we found. I'm sorry. Go ahead, Dipesh Prabhu.
No, sorry, Mataji. Go.
No, please. Maharaj, we found the book and we put both the links in the chat where devotees can purchase it.
It's really good. It's called Puranic. It has a real, real long history of the life of Prahlad Maharaj in here. Yeah, Prahlad is really, he's for about 50 pages that describes the life of Prahlad, his background, everything. Many Vidura's there, King Santanu, the three different Bharts. There were Bhart, the son of Rishabdev, Bhart, the son of Dasarath, and Bhart, son of Dushmanta. It's really an exact. Gokarn is there, Ishvaku, so many interesting, Astavarka, many great personalities.
Thank you, Maharaj.
But for Narada, you can go to Srimad-Bhagavatam, first canto. You'll find a little description on the life of Narada Muni.
Thank you, Maharaj. Lavanya Mataji, would you like to ask your question?
Yes, Mataji, thank you. Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj, please accept my humble obeisances. All goes to Srila Prabhupada. Guru Maharaj, I have a question. When I was reading Bhagavad Gita 10.6, where Lord Krishna says that the seven great sages and before them the four other great sages and the Manus come from me, born from my mind, and all the living beings populating the various planets descend from them. And after that, in the purport, Prabhupada is describing that, so from Brahma, so I could understand that from Brahma, all the seven sages and four Kumaras and Narada Muni, everyone came. And because of the energy of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, everyone are born. But when there is a statement that Brahma is the grandfather and Krishna is the father of the grandfather. Why it is mentioned like that, Guru Maharaj? I just want to clarify.
Why Krishna is called the father of the grandfather?
Yes, Guru Maharaj. Because when we say that from Brahma, Kumaras and sages and Narada Muni, everyone is coming, then we can call Brahma as father, right? So why they are calling as Brahma as grandfather and why Krishna is called as father of the grandfather?
Yeah, he's Maha Pitamaha. Brahma is called Pitamaha. Brahma, Tene Brahma Hidat Adi Kabaye, that's mentioned. Brahma appears from the lotus navel of Mahavishnu. When Mahavishnu laid down in the causal ocean, and then from then a lotus flower sprouted. From then, Brahma was born from the lotus flower. So Brahma's another name is called Ajah or Atmabhu. Both of these names, Ajah and Atmabhu, are names for Brahma, means he's born without a mother. He's self-born, but he comes directly from the Supreme Personality of God. That's the original Brahma. So, And that's mentioned in the Srimad Bhagavatam in the second canto. We're talking about Sarga and Visarga. The creation and the sub-creation. So he's part of the creation, but he's also involved in the sub-creation too. He's both. So he comes, the reason why Krishna is called the grandfather of the grandfather, or the father of the grandfather, is that because Brahma comes from Shiva, from Krishna, Mahavishnu.
Then we are treating Krishna, Lord Krishna, as father of the whole creation, right, Guru Maharaj?
Yeah, he says, Aham Bija Pita Pita. I am the seed-giving father of all living entities. And Brahma is considered the secondary creator. Mm-hmm. He gets his power for creation from Krishna himself. Tene Brahma Hida Adi Kaviye. So Krishna is the source and Brahma is his initial offspring in order to bring about the work of creation. And then from Brahma, yeah, then the sages come, and then we have Daksha, who is a Prajapati. Some of the sages are the Prajapatis. Then Kishyapa is a Prajapati, Daksha is a Prajapati. And what is their business is to produce thousands and thousands of living entities in different categories of the different species of life. And from them, the entire creation unfolds for the second millennium, for the next part of that millennium. In other words, after the millennium reappears, then this creative force again takes part. Is that clear?
Yes, Guru Maharaj, yeah. So even though these personalities are coming from Brahma, we can take that they are he is the secondary creator, and Krishna is the main seed giving father. So definitely that makes sense. Yeah,
we have to read the Bhagavatam. All of it's there in the Bhagavatam.
Yes, Guru Maharaj, sure.
Prabhupada said, he said it twice within a series of lectures. He said, everything you want to know, it's in Bhagavatam. Mm-hmm. If you know Bhagavatam, you know everything. And he didn't just mean spiritual, he meant everything. Those who take a serious study of Bhagavatam can find everything and anything on any subject in Srimad-Bhagavatam. It's all there.
Okay.
Bhagavatam's the best. We shouldn't just simply, just surreptitiously read it once in a while when we have time. To make it a study. Or listen to Prabhupada's classes on Bhagavatam, which he reveals more and more. You know, when I read Bhagavatam daily, and I find so many bits of information that are very much relevant to what's going on in the world today. In relationship to this, so-called pandemic we're supposed to be in. I find a lot of information that is connected to that. You just have to read and it comes, it just appears. Bhagavatam is complete. It's past, it's present, it's future. And it's completely transcendental. Those who study Bhagavatam, they find a wealth of spiritual and material information in the Srimad Bhagavatam. Material in the sense is that they understand how everything is working. Make it a lifestyle. There's been so many books on the Bhagavatam, just commentaries. I have one particular book on the Srimad Bhagavatam that done by one amazing devotee who just made it a study, and he just studied it for like a year, like every day for hours and hours, and then he wrote describing there's 10 main subjects in Bhagavatam, and he broke those 10 subjects down to smaller subjects and showed how they appear within the different verses in the Bhagavatam, and then the subcategories of the categories. Just like this verse we're reading now, it's just one small verse out of the 18,000 verses. But that whole purport or commentary is, you can speak on this verse for weeks, same verse. There's so much locked into each one of these verses. Prabhupada is giving us a little bit of it in his purports, but even within the purports, you can unlock more. When Prabhupada was on a morning walk with one very respectable and very intelligent professor in Germany, Professor Durkheim, he really had an attraction for Prabhupada in a real sense. And Prabhupada opened up on him and started glorifying Srimad Bhagavatam and explaining that it takes 1 month to understand each verse of Bhagavatam, 1 month. And then they multiplied that by 18,000 verses, and they came up with the 1,500 years. So Prabhupada said, you have enough to study. Just studying Srimad-Bhagavatam alone, you'll be self-realized. The fact that we're doing a Bhagavatam every day is a great credit. But that's just the beginning. Everything is there in Bhagavatam.
Yes, Guru Maharaj. Thank you so much. I'll read Guru Maharaj. Thank you.
you have these Bhagavatam discussion programs where yes. You pick a verse and you sit together with a few devotees and you read and you discuss. And you'd be surprised what you come up with.
Yes, Guru Maharaj, yeah.
And the point is, it takes us out of the material world into the spiritual world.
Thank you for a nice question, Lavanya Mataji. Such deep thought. We all benefit from it. Sri Devi Mataji, do you want to ask your question?
Yes, Anasuya, thank you so much. Please accept my humble obeisances, dear Guru Maharaj. All glories to Srila Prabhupada. All glories to the assembled devotees. Guru Maharaj, on the subject of Narad Muni, we understand what an exalted personality he is, and pure devotee of the Lord, and he only there facilitate the Lord's pastimes as well as to uplift the fallen souls. He's spiritual master to Dhruva Maharaj and Prahlad and like that. So, but growing up in India, you hear about Narad Muni. Oh, he's a mischief maker. Oh, he stirs up mischief wherever he goes. He incites people to start fighting and arguing, and creates conflict wherever he goes. That's the reputation he has, at least whatever I used to hear. And so he's considered like what he did with Kamsa. He incites him to, of course, facilitate the Lord's time, but he doesn't have a good reputation. Why is the Lord allowing such a thing to happen?
The last part of your question got cut off for some reason. Can you just rephrase your question again at the end?
Why is the Lord allowing such a thing to happen for his exalted devotee that he gets a bad rap?
Narada Muni is Narada Muni. People criticize Prabhupada too. People criticize Krishna also. People criticize everybody. This is the material world. They always find fault with. No matter who you are, somebody will find fault with you. Mm-hmm. That's just the way the world is. Krishna is criticized for dancing with 16,108 gopis, for breaking his promise, for saying he's not going to fight on the battlefield, and he broke his promise and fought anyway. People will criticize. It's just the way it is. Prabhupada says, the caravan, the dogs will bark and the caravan rolls on. So, and you should understand one thing. The more you become popular in this world, the more you make enemies, whether your popularity is in spiritual circles or in material circles, the more you make enemies, because that's the nature of this world. People are envious, and they always find some way to find fault. Finding fault is easy. Krishna doesn't defend himself. We defend Krishna. Krishna doesn't say, I'm God and whatever I do is right. People want to find fault with him. he lets them. He doesn't, you know, try to make a, you know, campaign of trying to rectify his reputation. So the same with great souls. They don't do anything. And so we can speak out. When people criticize, we can say something. We can set things right by understanding who he is, what his role is in assisting Krishna in his pastimes. Yeah, Daksa found so much fault with Narada. Daksa found fault with Shiva too. Daksa was a son of Brahma. Shiva was also a son of Brahma. Or at least he appeared through the body of Brahma, at least Lord Shiva. So even you see in this, in a higher spiritual realms, there's some competition, sometimes envy. It goes on.
Sridevi, you're on mute.
Yes, Guru Maharaj, thank you very much for showing the way out, because we can glorify, we can correct, we can explain who Narad Muni is when that situation happens. So that's very important to remember. Thank you very much for that. Hare Krishna.
Diptesh Prabhu, do you have a question? His hand is raised. I'm just...
No, sorry. Oh, no. That was from before.
Okay. That's sorry, fine. Just wanted to make sure that I did not, you know, acknowledge that you had a question. Thank you, Prabhu.
Thank you.
Are there other questions from devotees? Any clarification on this topic? Going down the list to make sure that I haven't missed anyone. Okay. If there isn't, Maharaj, would you like to end with one round, or would you like to end the class? It's your call, Maharaj. I know you do get tired, and I really feel bad when I ask you that, but I do know that you also like, and I want to do whatever you want me to do.
I would like to, but today I'm a little extra tired.
That is fine, Maharaj. We are your servants, Maharaj. You just instruct and we'll follow.
Let's give it a try and see what happens.
Maharaj, I don't want to inconvenience you. I feel bad now.
There's an old saying, when you're a little tired, you chant faster and you can stay awake. So that's the only way I'll be able to get through it. So if you can tolerate my accelerated attempt to stay awake.
We are at your service, Maharaj, whatever you want.
All right. When you say chant Hare Krishna, can anybody in any right mind refuse?
I'm sorry, Maharaj.
You trapped me by...
Oh, Krishna.
By knowing the only thing I couldn't say no to.
No, Maharaj, that was not a trap. No, Maharaj, I'm just because...
It's a good trap.
I know you've said that you've always liked to end the class with one, and I don't want to not follow your instruction. Please forgive me, Maharaj.
No, you're just doing your duty, so you're okay.
You can start whenever you want, Maharaj, and we'll follow
okay,
you.
Okay, ready?
Yes.
I'll do my best.
Yes,
Jai Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhar Sivasari Gaur Bhaktivrindam Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama. Rama Rama Hari Hari. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hari Hari, Hari Rama, Hari Rama, Rama Rama, Hari Hari, Hari Krishna, Hari Krishna, Krishna Hari Hari. Hari Rama, Hari Rama, Rama Rama, Hari Hari, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hari Hari. Hari Rama, Hari Rama, Rama Rama, Hari Hari. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hari Hari. Hari 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 Rama Hari Rama 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 Hari 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 Krishna Hari Krishna 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 Hari 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 Rama Hari Rama Rama Hari Hari Krishna Hari Krishna 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 Hari 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 Rama Hari Rama Hari Krishna Hari Krishna Krishna Hari 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 Rama Hari Rama Hari Krishna Hari Krishna Krishna Hari 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 Rama Hari Rama Hari Krishna Hari Krishna Krishna Hari 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 Rama Hari Rama Hari 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 Krishna Hari Krishna Krishna Hari 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 Rama Hari Rama Rama Hari Krishna Hari Krishna 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 Hari 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 Rama Hari Rama Rama Hari 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 Krishna Hari Krishna 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 Hari 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 Rama Hari Rama Rama Hari 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 Krishna 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 Hari 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 Rama Hari Rama Rama Hari 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 Krishna Hari Krishna Krishna Hari 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 Rama Hari Rama Rama Hari 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 Krishna Hari Krishna Krishna Hari 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 Rama Hari Rama Rama Hari 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 Krishna Hari Krishna Krishna Hari 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 Rama Hari Rama Rama Hari Krishna Hari Krishna Krishna Hari 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 Rama Hari Rama Rama Hari Hari Hare Krishna Hari Krishna 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 Hari 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 Rama Hari Rama Rama Hari 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 Krishna Hari Krishna Krishna Hari Hari Rama 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 Hari 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 Krishna Hari Krishna 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 Hari 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 Rama Hari Rama 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 Hari 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 Krishna Hari Krishna Krishna Hari 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 Rama, Hari Rama, Rama Rama, Hari Hari, Hari Krishna, 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 Hari Hari, Hari Rama, Hari Rama, Rama Rama, Hari Hari, Hari Krishna, Hari Krishna, Hari Hari, Hari Rama, Hari Rama, Hari Krishna, Hari Krishna, Krishna, Hari Hari, Hari Rama, Rama, Hari Hari, Hari Krishna, Hari Krishna, Krishna, Hari Hari, Hari Rama, Hari Krishna, Hari Krishna, Hari Hari, Hari Rama, Hari Rama, Hari Krishna, Hari Hari, Hari Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Hare. Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Hare. Hari Rama, Hari Rama, Rama Rama, Hari Krishna, Hari Krishna, Krishna Hari. Hari Hari, Hari Rama, Hari Rama, Rama Hari Krishna, Hari Krishna, Krishna Hari Hari. Hari Rama, Hari Rama, Rama Hari Krishna, Hari Krishna, Krishna Hari Hari. Hari Rama, Hari Rama, Hari Krishna, Hari Krishna, Krishna Hari Hari. Hari Rama, Hari Rama, Hari Krishna, Hari Krishna, Krishna Hari Hari. Hari Rama, Hari Rama, Hari Krishna, Hari Krishna, Krishna Hari Hari. Hari Rama, Hari Rama, Rama Rama, Hari Hari, Hari Krishna. Krishna 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 Hari 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 Krishna Hari Krishna 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 Hari 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 Rama Hari Rama Hari Krishna Hari Krishna Hari 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 Rama Hari Rama Hari Krishna Hari Krishna Krishna Hari 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 Rama Hari Rama Hari Krishna Hari Krishna Hari 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 Rama Hari Rama Hari Krishna Hari Krishna Hari 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 Rama Hari Rama Hari 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 Krishna Hari Krishna Rama 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 Hari 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 Krishna Hari Krishna 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 Hari Hari Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare. Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Hare Rama. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama. Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Krishna Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama. Hare Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Thank you very much, Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Sri Hari Nam and Sankirtan ki jai.
Thank you so much, Maharaj. And we thank you to all the devotees for joining our class. Vanchakrapti Biyascha Kripa Sindhu Bevacha Patitanam Pavanevyo Vaishnavevyo Namo Namaha Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai. His Holiness Candramauli Swami Ki Jai. Thank you so much, Maharaj.
Hare Krishna. Thank you, Guru Maharaj.
I always look forward to meeting you every 2 weeks.
I feel fortunate, Maharaj. I feel so fortunate just by you saying it. I feel so blessed. Thank you so much, Maharaj, for your mercy.
I'm, you know, your god sister Chit Shakti?
Yes.
Doing a program on your Guru Maharaj's disappearance.
Disappearance.
Yeah, on the 27th of this month, which is the actual date of his death disappearance.
Mm-hmm.
At 4 3 p.m. UK time.
Okay.
But get with Chit Shakti, and we're doing I'm going to be speaking from the Beggar 4.
Oh, okay. I will definitely do that.
That's on the 27th, which is in another 10 days. Yeah.
Sunday, right. I will definitely connect with her, Marge, and I'll get all the details from her.
Yeah, I think there's a large group that's going to be part of that program. So
nice. Yeah. I will do that, Marge. Thank you so much for letting me know, Marge. Thank you.
Okay, thank you.
Hare Krishna, Marge.
Jai Om, my obeisances. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.